what you try to be. Your individuality, when the world is on your shoulders, just smile and let it go. If people try to put you down, just walk on by, don't turn around. You only have to answer to yourself. Don't you know it's true?
Hey y'all!
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna get kinda real. We're talking post-undergrad. What does that mean? Basically when your life is over after college. Or what the hell you're gonna do after you graduate. It's tough. It's not an easy transition from college to the adult world. Nobody tells you what you're supposed to do. You kind of just figure it out. I kind of had like a pre-midlife crisis the other day, and I normally don't get emotional, but like I felt like I needed to get my life right, and I just didn't feel like I was doing anything with my life. So I was like, what am I doing? I don't know what to do that. So yeah, there was a lot going on last week, and I was just thinking about, you know, life after college and trying to make that transition from college student to, you know, grown-ass adult. I just kind of wanted to give you guys some advice for what I'm doing and a couple of things that my friends were telling me about. So this is all based off of the things that my friends and I kind of came up with, and hopefully these tips and suggestions will help you navigate through the real world, because it's kind of scary. So enough talking, let's jump right into it, and here we go! There's no prescribed timeline for your life. Regardless of the fact that everyone wants you to carve a straight highway through the Himalayas, it doesn't work like that. You don't have to know what you're supposed to be doing or doing what you think you're supposed to be doing. Life happens at a different pace for everyone. There's so much stress just to figure out what you're supposed to be doing and figuring that out early. And it feels like everyone else has kind of got their life going together. You know, some people got jobs already straight out of college or while they're still in their last year of college. And then you are sitting here like, like, where my job at? You're definitely not alone. This is something that everyone is kind of going through. I'm pretty sure everyone in America is going through this. It doesn't mean that you're doing something wrong. Just because it seems like everyone else has got their life together and you feel like you don't necessarily, doesn't mean that you're doing it wrong. Life is done in so many different ways, like billions of different ways that you can live life. And so what if you're fun employed? Take it as like summertime forever. You have so much free time to find different things that you'd like to do, explore those things that you didn't really have time for while you were in college. And just embrace it, because when you do get a job, you really won't have a lot of time on your hands to do those things that you love. So go ahead and learn French, practice your ABCs, learn how to spell your name backwards, or hold your breath for a minute, because I actually don't really recommend that, because, you know, brain cells and stuff, they're kind of important. Above all else, you are not lesser than anyone else just because you don't have a job. Point blank, like, damn. So, you good, you right, you fine, don't worry about it, it'll happen. So there's that saying that it's not what you know, it's kind of who you know. And as much as I hate to admit that, it's kind of true. Any opportunity you get to meet a new person or talk to somebody's parent or talk to a previous professor or whoever, make those connections, have conversations in general. You never know what conversations can lead to. Simple conversations, simple dialogue can lead to really amazing things down the line. Yeah, just gotta open up your mouth and, you know, chat it up a little bit. Just chat it up just a little bit, not too much. Another thing you could do is reach out to the people whose stories or jobs interest you. If you know somebody who's doing something within an industry that you really want to get into, talk to them or talk to somebody that knows them. Make that kind of chain of connections that will kind of get you to where you need to be going, or at least on that track. And if you do happen to find those opportunities along the way, keep those connections intact. Those connections plus that specific opportunity can lead to more opportunities and stuff that you can put on your resume. Convention is old news, so why not get a little creative in your job hunt? You can recreate your resume as design, GIF, website, or even YouTube. It might work. Be someone who stands out. Anything that you do, stand out. Don't just be like everyone else. Do something that's totally different from what everyone else is doing. Get creative, and you never know where it could lead to. And speaking of creativity, you can create yourself by being your own boss, aka next future entrepreneur / rich white dude. And if all else fails, tequila. This is so, so, so important. Sometimes you just gotta put pride aside and just ask for help. If you need help finding a job, or if you feel like nothing's really working and just need some advice, talk to somebody about it. And that could be in the form of a mom.
Mom, I need college advice.
Or a friend, or a reference, or a resource, something. Just talk to somebody about it. Especially if you need a little extra cash to help you through. People are not gonna say no if you do need help. Don't be afraid. I got you. I mean, except I'm broke too, so like, I mean, we could be in this together, like. When you see an opportunity to make a jump, jump. And the worst that could ever happen is an adventure. Just because you study this particular subject in college does not mean you have to stick to it for a year, 5 years, or 50 years down the line. You can change your mind at any time, you can change your career at any time, you can change your major of life at any time. Your degree does not define you, but it can certainly help shape the place you'll be in your future. But nonetheless, explore, adventure, and change your mind as many damn times as you want. And if somebody tries to stop you, push them. So this is kind of straight to the point. Just take every rejection as sort of a redirection to where you're supposed to be going. Life kind of has a weird way of working itself out. It's kind of a scary but kind of beautiful thing if you think about it. And living the dream rarely looks like what it's supposed to look like. I mean, gosh, what does it look like though? Embrace every single struggle, every single opportunity, every single blessing, and every single wonderful thing that's coming your way. You just gotta be patient. So you want to achieve the American dream, but you don't want to work hard for it. Look at you. Look at you. You must embrace your mistakes. There is absolutely no manual for becoming an adult. And that just means that you just gotta make hella mistakes before your body decides, oh yeah, I'm an adult now, woo! Becoming an adult is not like graduation. Nobody just hands you a diploma and says, here, you're an adult now. You kind of already are, but you're just sort of figuring out yourself as an adult person. And in order to figure most of that out is through trial and error. So making mistakes isn't actually a bad thing. Now, there's some other mistakes you could be making that are actually bad things, so you're gonna stay away from that if you know what I'm talking about, because I'm not sure what I'm talking about, but I think you know what I'm talking about. So yeah, don't do those. Be willing to do your best. Be willing to challenge yourself. Be willing to take a step back when you need to breathe. Be open. Be open to the ways you can change yourself, and be open to the people that could change you. Be kind to yourself, be kind to your body, and don't forget to have fun. Know that the world is waiting for you, and damn sure know that we are gonna wait as long as it takes for you to realize what you truly are capable of, all that you're capable of, and all that you're gonna make this world to be. Because we need you. We need your gifts. We need your talents. We need your voice. You are so important, and your life is everything. You have so much worth and potential to contribute in your own way to your community and to the community at large. And the last thing I'm gonna say is never underestimate what you're capable of. Even if you go through 1,001 challenges or 1,001 mistakes, at the end of it all, it's gonna be worth it, because we will have another leader who will take us to where we gotta go. And that, my friend, is you. So go out and change the world. So that's all for today. Thank you all so, so much for watching. I hope that these suggestions and ideas really helped you out, because they really, really helped me out, and they kind of made me cry a little bit. So just remember that you're special, you're worthy, you're capable, and you damn sure gonna make it. So live it up.